नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस वी विल सी कूलिंग विथ डिह्यूमिडिफिकेशन. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दिस, कूलिंग विथ डिह्यूमिडिफिकेशन इट इज मोस्टली यूज इन समर एयर कंडीशनर. नाउ इफ एटमोस्फियरिक टेम्परेचर इट इज हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड, ओके, वी रिक्वायर कूलिंग एंड डिह्यूमिडिफिकेशन. सो बेसिकली कूलिंग विथ डिह्यूमिडिफिकेशन, दिस प्रोसेस इट इज यूज इन समर एसी when the conditions are hot and humid. Now what is done in this cooling with dehumidification? Water vapor is removed from air by cooling air below its dew point temperature. Okay, so this process we will see in the next slide in detail. So here you can see a duct has been shown, and this is the cooling coil. Suppose in the cooling coil refrigerant is entering, and this is entry of the air 0.1 and this is exit of the air 0.2. Surface temperature of the cooling coil, it is denoted by ADP. Okay, this is a new terminology. Okay, here you can read the definition of that. The surface temperature of cooling and dehumidifying coil is known as apparatus dew point temperature. Okay, so this cooling coil is an apparatus. Okay, so that is why it is called apparatus dew point temperature, ADP. Okay, now this ADP, it is less than this ADP, this value, it is less than dew point temperature TDP of entering air. Okay, so because of that, what will happen? This air, it will lose its moisture. That is why this process is called cooling with dehumidification. So temperature is reduced as well as moisture is removed from the air. Okay, so it is called cooling with dehumidification. Now we will see the actual process and the analysis of process. So here you can see at entry we have TD1, at exit we have TD2, dry bulb temperature of entering air, dry bulb temperature of exiting air. Okay, and surface temperature of coil, it is less than dew point temperature TDP of entering air. And surface temperature of cooling and dehumidifying coil, it is known as apparatus dew point temperature ADP. Now please remember that this definition is asked in the exam many times. Define ADP. So you have to write down this definition. You can draw the diagram to explain it. Okay, this TS means this will be ADP for cooling with dehumidification. Now we will see the cooling with dehumidification process and analysis part of that. So here psychrometric chart is shown and here temperature versus length diagram is shown, and this is the setup part. Air is entering at 0.1 whose temperature is TD1. Air is exiting at 0.2 whose temperature is TD2. And surface temperature of coil, it is less than dew point temperature of entering air. Okay, so I'll show that point on psychrometric chart. So this is the 0.1 which I have marked. Its enthalpy is H1. Its specific humidity is omega 1. Its dry bulb temperature is TD1. That point I have marked on temperature versus length diagram as well. Now after this, there will be cooling with dehumidification. Now understand the significance of this process. What is dew point temperature of 0.1? For 0.1, you should draw a horizontal line. Okay, from here, if you draw a horizontal line, wherever it intersects the saturation curve where relative humidity is 100%, that temperature is TD P1. Okay, dew point temperature of entering air, TD P1. Now the coil temperature TS, it should be less than dew point temperature. So somewhere over here that coil temperature is there. So process will be like this. And since the temperature of air, it is reduced below the dew point temperature of entering air, you can see here this is omega 1 and omega 2 value, it will be less. Why? Because there is dehumidification. So temperature is reducing, that is why cooling, and omega is reducing, that is why dehumidification. So this is point S, TS, surface temperature, that is also known as ADP, surface temperature of cooling and dehumidifying coil. Okay, so this lower temperature I have shown over here, TS, that is maintained constant surface temperature of cooling coil. Now air enters over here and because of bypass, okay, 0.2 temperature will not be exactly over point S. Okay, there will be some bypass. So I have shown 0.2 over here. okay, and this is how the process will be there. So for point 2, which is at this location, TD2 is this value on x-axis, this is TD2, this is omega 2 on the right side, and this is specific enthalpy of point 2. Okay, and see the process on temperature versus length diagram. Bottom side, this is surface temperature of the coil, and at entry higher temperature is there and it is cooled to lower temperature TD2. So this is about the temperature part. Now we will see the analysis of this. Now what I have done over here, draw vertical from point 1 in downward direction, draw horizontal from point 2 towards right. Wherever they intersect, that point I am denoting as point A. Now I can read enthalpy of point A also here. You can see this is enthalpy of point A. Now very important question I am going to ask. Please think about this. If you consider process 1 to 2, it can be divided into two parts. One is process 1 to A and second is process A to 2. Okay, so please think about this. During process 1 to A, dry bulb temperature is changing, dry bulb temperature is not changing. Okay, meaning this will be which type of heat? Latent heat. Okay, so H1 minus HA will give us latent heat of this process 1 to 2. Now if you consider HA minus H2, here dry bulb temperature is changing or not? It is reducing, na? Meaning here there will be sensible heat. So HA minus H2, this part will be what? Sensible heat. Now understand this. So that is why I have shown over here HA minus H2, this part is sensible heat. Why? Because from A to 2, dry bulb temperature is changing. And if you consider H1 minus HA, here dry bulb temperature is remaining same. So this is latent heat part. Now this sensible heat and this latent heat, it is of which process? 1 to 2. So 1 to 2 process, we have divided that into sensible heat and latent heat. Then what is the total heat? Total heat will be H1 minus H2. Okay, so this is TH, total heat. Okay, now what is the rate at which heat is extracted from the air? Q dot A is equal to M dot dA into higher enthalpy, which is H1, minus lower enthalpy, which is H2. Now understand the units over here. Mass flow rate of air, unit is kg of dry air per second. Okay, kg of dry air per second. And what is the unit of enthalpy, specific enthalpy? It is kilojoule per kg of dry air. This kg of dry air and this kg of dry air will get cancelled, and finally unit will be kilojoule per second, and same unit you can observe on left hand side of the equation. Okay, so this is about rate at which heat is extracted from the air. Okay, this you have to use in numericals. Next, capacity of dehumidifier. Now since this is cooling with dehumidification, what is the capacity of dehumidifier, or it is also called dehumidification rate, or it is also called water removal rate. In numericals, any of these three words can be used. Equation will remain same. Capacity is equal to mass flow rate of dry air multiplied by difference of specific humidity. Higher specific humidity is omega 1 and lower specific humidity is omega 2. Now understand the units. M dot dA unit is kg of dry air per second, and omega unit is kg of water vapor per kg of dry air. So kg of dry air will get cancelled, and unit which remains on right hand side, it will be kg of water vapor per second, and that is what is known as this dehumidification rate. What is the kg of water vapor removed per second from the air? Okay, so that is why unit of capacity is kg of water vapor per second. Next, if you want to calculate m dot dA, as we have seen in the numerical of sensible heating, m dot dA, it will be equal to v dot A upon specific volume of the point, whatever v dot A point is given in the question. For that, we have to read specific volume of point 1 from psychrometric chart to calculate m dot dA. Next, coil bypass factor, it will be TD2 minus TS upon TD1 minus TS. It can be written in terms of length also, as we have seen during the sensible heating part. What will be the length? Length 2S upon length 1s. Okay, you can measure the length using the scale on psychrometric chart, and then you can calculate the coil bypass factor. You will get the same answer. Either you can use this equation of temperature or you can measure the length. Next, if bypass factor is not given, okay, now here understand that this bypass factor is given in the question, that is why 0.2, it is on the right of point S. Okay, this 0.2 is not able to reach point S. But suppose in numerical bypass factor is not given, in that case what we will assume, this 0.2 and point S overlaps. If bypass factor is neither given nor asked, assume it to be 0 and process will be from 1 to S. It is related to numericals. So in that case, what we can write, for 0.2, TD2, dry bulb temperature equal to wet bulb temperature equal to dew point temperature at 0.2 is equal to ADP. Next, it might be asked in numerical to calculate what is sensible heat factor. Okay, it is denoted by SHF, sensible heat factor. What is the equation of that sensible heat factor? It is sensible heat. Okay, here you can see this is sensible heat upon total heat. What is sensible heat? HA minus H2. So here you can see HA minus H2 divided by total heat, it will be H1 minus H2. So divided by H1 minus H2. So this formula basically you can remember from the process itself. Okay, understand the concept. By the concept directly you can apply the formula. So we will be continuing with numericals on psychrometric processes. So we will go through this question. The atmospheric air at 30 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 75% RH enters a cooling coil at a rate of 200 meter cube per minute. So here you can see I have shown a duct and this is a cooling coil. Now air is entering at point 1. This is the direction of the flow of air. Dry bulb temperature of 0.1, it is 30 degree Celsius, and RH of 0.1 is 75%. Enters a cooling coil at a rate of 200 meter cube per minute. So V dot A1 is given 200 meter cube per minute. So divided by 60, you will get 3.33 meter cube per second. The coil dew point temperature is 14 degree Celsius. Okay, now there is difference between inlet air dew point temperature and coil dew point temperature. Here what is given? Coil dew point temperature, meaning this is ADP, cooling and dehumidifying coil. So coil temperature TS, surface temperature, it is also denoted by ADP equal to 14 degree Celsius. And bypass factor of the coil is 0.1. So BPF value is given. I'll write down that value. BPF is equal to 0.1. Now data for 0.2 is not given, okay, and all the data related to 0.2 we will get after locating 0.1 and then after using this 30 and 75 we have to locate 0.1, then mark this TS, surface temperature, and using this bypass factor we will get 0.2. Okay, now the steps involved over here are same as we discussed during the theory session. Okay, already we have discussed the basics of this cooling and dehumidification process. Okay, so same equations whatever we have studied in theory, that we have to apply over here. So first we will calculate what is dew point temperature, DPT of 0.1. So TDP of 0.1, that we will find out. So in order to find out this value, we need to plot point number 1 on psychrometric chart. Okay, so I'll go to the psychrometric chart and please understand how this plotting is done. So here you can observe the psychrometric chart. Now this psychrometric chart, it is valid for 1.01325 bar pressure. Now 0.1 temperature, dry bulb temperature, it is given as 30 degree Celsius. So here you can see we have 30 degree Celsius. So I have drawn a blue line, vertical blue line. This is 30 degree Celsius, vertical blue line. Now RH of 0.1, it is given as 75%. So if you see this, this is RH equal to 70% and this is RH equal to 80%. So in between, this one is RH equal to 75%. So I have marked RH equal to 75% on vertical dry bulb temperature line. Okay, so that will be point number one. After locating point number one, what is the next data given? ADP temperature is given. What is ADP temperature? That we can mark on the psychrometric chart. Okay, now ADP temperature is given as 14 degrees Celsius. So here you can see this is 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, dew point temperature are horizontal lines. So this is 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. And ADP is given as 14. So this is the point. Okay, what is this point? It will be surface temperature of coil. Okay, so here I have marked this point as TS, surface temperature equal to ADP equal to 14 degrees Celsius. So now we will join point 1 with point S using straight line. Okay, now based on dry bulb temperature which was 30 degrees Celsius, RH 75%, we got point 1. Then using ADP, we marked the ADP on saturation curve and joined 1 and S. So this is how we have drawn process 1 to S. Okay, now we will read what is the dew point temperature of point 1. Okay, point 1 is entering air. So dew point temperature, you have to draw horizontal wherever it cuts the saturation curve. Here you can read dew point temperature. It is approximately 25.5 degrees Celsius. So I'll write down dew point temperature of entering air, TDP 1. It is 25.5 degrees Celsius. And ADP value, apparatus dew point, meaning surface temperature of cooling coil, that is less than dew point temperature of entering air, TDP 1. So this process is cooling with dehumidification. Did you understand how we found that this process is cooling with dehumidification? We found, first we located point 1, then we located TS, which is coil ADP, joined 1 with S, and after that we compared the ADP value, which is 14 degrees Celsius, with dew point temperature of entering air, that is 25.5. Now that ADP, it is less than dew point temperature of entering air, that is why this process is cooling with dehumidification. Now after understanding about the process, okay, this process is cooling with dehumidification, we can start with the calculation part. Okay, now what is asked? Temperature of air leaving the cooling coil. Okay, now in order to calculate that temperature, okay, that temperature, suppose that point 2 location is over here. Okay, for example, point 2 location is over here. So how we will get the point 2 temperature? We have to use bypass factor equation. Okay, bypass factor is given in the question. How to use bypass factor? It will be TD2 minus TS. Okay, we are talking about dry bulb temperature. So TD2 minus TS divided by TD1 minus TS. So using this, TD1 value we know, TDS value we know, bypass factor we know. So only unknown is TD2. Once we know TD2, we can mark point number 2 and get whatever is asked in the question. Okay, so I'll write down bypass factor equation. So bypass factor, which is equal to 0.1. What is the equation of bypass factor? TD2 minus TS upon TD1 minus TS. Okay, now substitute the values here. TD2 value we have to calculate. Okay, what is asked in the question? Temperature of air leaving the cooling coil. What is the notation used for that? 2. Okay, so we have to calculate TD2. So I'll write down this is first sub question, which is calculation of TD2. Okay, so TD2 we have to calculate minus surface temperature of coil, which is ADP 14, divided by TD1. It is given in the question 30 degrees Celsius, 30 minus surface temperature 14. So only unknown in this equation is TD2. So TD2 we can calculate. TD2 is equal to 15.6 degree Celsius. Now once we have calculated TD2 temperature, we can locate point number 2. How? Go to the psychrometric chart. Okay, now see this. This is 15 dry bulb temperature and this is 20 dry bulb temperature. Okay, and we have 5 divisions. So this will be 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, and what is the value which we have calculated? 15.6. So I have marked this is 15 and this is 16. Okay, so 15.6 I have marked over here, and draw a vertical from that 15.6. wherever it intersects incline line 1 to S, that will be point number 2. So in this way I have located point number 2. Now once I locate point number 2, I can calculate the rest of the questions. Okay, so we'll go back to the question. Next, what is asked? The capacity of cooling coil in tons of refrigeration and kilowatt. So we have to find the capacity of this cooling coil. Now this cooling coil, it is cooling the air from TD1, which is at 30 degrees Celsius, to TD2, which is at 15.6 degrees Celsius. Okay, so how to calculate the capacity? It will be Q dot A equal to M dot dA into higher enthalpy minus lower enthalpy. Now if you see the process 1 to 2, this is 0.1 and this is 0.2. What is the higher enthalpy? It will be H1, which you can read over here. So here you can see I have drawn inclined line. Wherever it cuts the enthalpy scale, there you have to read the value of enthalpy. Okay, so this is 80. 81 and 82. So H1 is 82 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Same way, this is the 0.2. So we can read value of H2. Okay, extend this. Okay, this line, it is parallel to this wet bulb temperature or enthalpy line. Okay, so these are the enthalpy lines, inclined ones. So I have to keep the roller scale parallel to this line. Okay, and then roll the scale and from 0.2 draw that line. Okay, so wherever it intersects the specific enthalpy scale, there you have to read the enthalpy value. Now here if you see this value, this is 45, so this will be 44. Okay, so I have written H2 value as 44 kilojoule per kg of dry air. So we have found value of H1, we have found value of H2 from psychrometric chart. Okay, now we'll write down the equation of Q dot A. Okay, what is asked? Capacity of cooling coil. Okay, so what is the heat extracted by the cooling coil? That we have to calculate. So I'll write down second sub question. It is capacity of cooling coil. You have to find it in TR as well as kilowatt. Okay, here it has been given. We have to find the capacity of cooling coil in tons, TR and kilowatt. So now what is the equation of this? Q dot A is equal to M dot dA into higher enthalpy is H1 minus lower enthalpy is H2. We have to consider actual process, right? Why? Because bypass factor is given. So don't take here H1 minus HS. Okay. We have to take process 1 to 2. So that is why H1 minus H2. Now how to calculate this M dot dA? M dot dA, it is equal to V dot A1 upon specific volume of 0.1. Okay, now V dot A1 value, that is given in the question. What is that value? It is 3.33 meter cube per second. So substitute that value, 3.33 divided by specific volume of 0.1. Now you will get this specific volume of 0.1 from psychrometric chart. So go back to the psychrometric chart. This is 0.1. okay, so you have to read the value of specific volume. These are specific volume lines. So here you can read the value. This is 0.75 meter cube per kg. This is 0.8 meter cube per kg. 0.85, 0.9. Okay, now 0.1. Keep your roller scale at this line, incline line, and draw parallel passing through 0.1. Okay, now it will intersect somewhere on the x-axis. Now what I have done over here, understand. This point, it is 0.85 meter cube per kg, specific volume. And this point, it is 0.9 meter cube per kg. So I have divided it in 5 equal parts, 0.86, 87, 88, 89, and 9, 0.9. So this value, approximately I have found out, it is 0.886 meter cube per kg. What is this? Specific volume of 0.1. Okay, so I'll use this value now. So specific volume of 0.1, it is 0.886. So from here I can calculate mass flow rate of dryer. So m dot da is equal to 3.785 kg of dryer per second. Okay, now once we calculate this m dot da value, we can substitute this value in the equation which we have written over here. So m dot da is 3.785 into h1 value. We have read that from psychrometric chart, it was 82 minus h2, it is 44. So from here we will get q dot a in kilowatt. Okay, that value is 142.804 kilowatt. Now this value of Q dot A, we have to calculate in kilowatt as well as TR, tons of refrigeration. Okay, so TR value of this, it will be how to calculate that. Q dot A is equal to 3.5 into capacity. So capacity is equal to Q dot A, 142.804 divided by 3.5. So capacity is equal to 40.8 TR. So we have calculated sub question number 2, capacity of cooling coil in tons of refrigeration and kilowatt. Next, the amount of water vapor removed per minute. Okay, now since this coil, it is cooling and dehumidifying coil, so omega, it will reduce specific humidity. It will reduce from omega 1 to omega 2. Okay, so we have to calculate what is the amount of water vapor removed per minute. Be careful here, this is per minute, not per second. Okay, so I'll write down the heading. Sub question number 3. We have to find amount of water vapor removed per minute. Okay, now what is the equation of this? This will be equal to m dot da into specific humidity of 0.1 minus specific humidity of 0.2. Now specific humidity of 0.1 and 0.2 we have to read from psychrometric chart. Okay, m dot da1 value we already know. What is that value? 3.758. In bracket omega 1 value we will read from chart. Okay, so here you can see this is 0.1. How to read omega value? Draw horizontal from 0.1 towards right. Wherever it cuts, horizontal cuts the, intersects the y-axis, that will give specific humidity value. Okay, so here I can read the value. It is 0.026 kg of water vapor per kg of dryer. Similarly, this is 0.2. Draw horizontal from 0.2, wherever it intersects the vertical. Okay, that there you have to read the value of specific humidity of 0.2. It is omega 2 equal to 0.011 kg of water vapor per kg of dryer. Okay, now we can substitute these values in the equation which we have written there. So omega value we can substitute over here. Omega 1, it is 0.0206 minus omega 2, 0.011. So using this we can calculate amount of water vapor removed per second. Okay, so that value is 0.036 kg of water vapor removed per second. Okay, now we require answer per minute. Okay, so multiply by 60. So this answer will be 2.16 kg of water vapor per minute. Next question we will see. Sensible heat factor for the process. Now equation of sensible heat factor, we will write it down. This we have seen in theory part. So sensible heat factor, SHF. What is sensible heat factor, SHF? It is equal to sensible heat upon total heat. Okay, now sensible heat value we have to read from psychrometric chart as well as total heat value. Okay, so we'll go to the psychrometric chart. Now understand how to calculate sensible heat factor. Okay, now on the right hand side you can see here one scale is there, sensible heat factor scale. Okay, so once we calculate the sensible heat factor, it can be plotted on this scale. Okay, in this numerical that we don't have to do that part, we will see this part later. Okay, in the appropriate numerical we will be actually plotting the sensible heat factor value on the sensible heat factor scale, that we will see later on. Okay, now what we have to do, from point 1 draw a line which is vertically downward direction. Okay, this is the line, and from point 2 draw horizontal line towards right, wherever they intersect, that is point A. Now this is enthalpy line. Okay, so keep your roller scale to this line. Okay, and roll the scale and draw line parallel from point 1 and read the value of enthalpy, specific enthalpy of point A. Okay, so if I extend this point, okay, if I draw line from point A, okay, parallel to the enthalpy lines, here I can read the value of specific enthalpy of point A. Now this is 60, so this will be HA value will be 59 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Now please understand here, this part we had discussed before also. For point 1 and for point A, dry bulb temperature, it is changing or not? Is it same or is it different? Same, right? So dry bulb temperature of point 1 and point A, it is same. Meaning if you consider H1 minus HA, that will be latent heat. Okay, now you have to consider the dry bulb temperature. Dry bulb temperature of point A and dry bulb temperature of point 2, it is same or different? Different, right? So here dry bulb temperature is changing from A to 2, meaning this is which type of heat? Sensible heat. Okay, so HA minus H2 will give sensible heat. So what is sensible heat factor? It is sensible heat upon total heat. What is sensible heat? It is HA minus H2. Okay, so 59 minus 44, that is sensible heat. And what is total heat? H1 minus H2. Okay, so that value will be 82 minus 44. Okay, so I'll write down the equation. Okay, so we'll go back to the calculation part. So sensible heat factor, this equation you can write from the psychrometric chart. Okay, so this will be equal to sensible heat, which is HA minus H2 upon total heat, and total heat is H1 minus H2. Okay, substitute the values here, 59 minus 44 divided by 82 minus 44. So we can calculate SHF, it is equal to 0.39. Now what is the meaning of SHF? this we will see when we design air conditioning system. Okay, there this part we will see in more detail. What is meaning of this? See, basically what is meaning of this? I'll give you a rough idea. When we have drawn this, if we mark the SHF, okay, over here, suppose that value is known, which is 0.39. Okay, so that value will be somewhere over here. Okay, and if you join that with alignment circle, which is shown over here, okay, that line, it will have certain slope. Okay, so I'll draw it like this. This will be the line. So if the air which we are supplying, if that is maintained on this slope, it will pick up the required sensible heat and latent heat. That is the meaning of that sensible heat factor. Okay, that will be more clear when we actually design that air conditioning system. Okay, in that case, we will see again this part in detail. Okay, here I have just given you introduction of that SHF, but in detail we will study in next module. Okay, so we will go back to this numerical and quickly revise this numerical. Okay, what is given in this numerical? Atmospheric air at 30 degree Celsius dry bulb, so TD1 is given and 75% RH1 is given, and volume flow rate of air V dot A1 is given. We converted that meter cube per minute to meter cube per second. Okay, now surface temperature of coil, it is given as 14 degree Celsius and 0.2 data is not given. Okay, bypass factor is given as 0.1. So what we did, first we located 0.1, dry bulb temperature is 30 and RH is 75%. So this is 70, this is 80. So here there will be 75. So I marked point number one. Then after that, ADP value is 14. So this is ADP 14. This is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So ADP is marked. So after that, I have joined point one and point S. Then I have found out dew point temperature of point one. It is 25.5. Okay, compared it with this 14. Since ADP is less than dew point temperature of entering air, this process is cooling with dehumidification. That conclusion we have drawn. Okay, now after that, using bypass factor equation, what is bypass factor? It is TD2 minus TS upon TD1 minus TS. Okay, TD1 is known, TS is known. So we got TD2, okay, and bypass factor was given in the question. So we got TD2, that value was 15.6. So here on the chart, we mark that 15.6 and dry bulb temperature and draw a vertical from that. Wherever it intersected, this vertical, wherever it intersected this 1S, there we located 0.2. Okay, now after that, we have drawn vertical from point in downward direction, then horizontal from point 2 in right side, wherever it intersected, that is point A. We have to read value of H1, HA, H2. We have to read value of omega 1 and omega 2. Why? Because that was asked in the question. Okay. So after that, we applied the formulas. Okay. We calculated TD2 using bypass factor. Then when capacity of coil was asked, okay, it was m dot dA into H1 minus H2, m dot dA, it is calculated by this equation. Okay, and H1, H2 we read from chart. Okay, so we got Q dot A and then capacity. Then how to calculate amount of water vapor removed per minute using this equation, and omega 1, omega 2 we read from the chart. Okay, and then sensible heat factor scale, we have applied this equation, and this equation we get from the psychrometric chart itself. Okay, after locating the points. And we calculated this value of sensible heat factor.